Welcome.
Okay, welcome to episode 7 of the Grizzly Show podcast. Today we're talking about the Growl. My name is Heavenly. I'm the editor-in-chief of the Growl.
I'm Clara. Well, I'm the social media manager.
I'm Kenzie. I'm an editor.
I'm Drake, and I'm our calendar czar.
And let's go ahead and get started talking about the origins of the Growl. So it started the first year that the school opened. Drake, I believe you were the only person that had actually signed up to join, to take newspaper.
The only person, and then I convinced Heavenly to join.
Mm-hmm. Yes, because I was taking theater tech, even though I wanted to be in theater, so I just switched to newspaper accidentally and fell in love with it.
I was in theater tech, and then I remember you and then Miss Millar all came in, and you were like, hey guys, join newspaper. Like, please, please join newspaper.
Because I was the only one with cat.
Right. Wasn't it just like four people in there or something?
Yeah.
And then like a bunch of the theater tech kids were like, you know what? We don't actually care about theater. And then we went to newspaper.
I was just switched in here and I was like, wow.
Yeah. Clairville joined her freshman year, which was our sophomore year. So after we had already kind of established things.
Honorary sophomore.
She's an honorary sophomore.
It was interesting because we had no idea where to begin in newspaper and journalism specifically. I had never taken a journalism class ever. And so it was cool to learn from nothing.
Yeah, it was really cool. We had to spend a lot of time in the beginning kind of like learning journalism basics and learning how to write and stuff like that. But then we all really got into it once we learned about it. And I guess that kind of brings us to the next point, how we learned. Yeah, our teacher, she kind of made us like PowerPoints on how to write and stuff like that. And we practiced a lot with UIL prompts for UIL academics in journalism, how to write stories like that.
We learned the importance of journalism, what it does for society and what we can do for our student body and our staff and our community.
Become like their voice.
Yeah, we talked a lot about the history of journalism, so I feel like we all kind of understand how it's like a lot more than just a student publication. It's something a lot more that represents like, you know, years and years of people trying to like inform the public and be a voice for the public as well.
So the Growl is the name of our newspaper here at Glen High School. And we started in 2016, and we have constantly been trying to push out relevant news stories for everyone here at GHS. And we have different categories of stories, which Clarabelle can go into.
Yes, we have news stories, which are just like the current present stories of the school and like what's going on.
They're just more informative.
Yeah. And then we have editorials, which are just like the staff opinions on whatever is happening in the school, like if there's like a new microwave and stuff like that. And we also have sports stories, which covers sports. And we have reviews and such of like different books and concerts and stuff that we go to.
Yeah, and then we do feature stories.
Oh, yes, feature stories of the students in the school and the great things they've done.
So, students, different organizations, or like groups of people, we just kind of talk to them and write stories about them.
We also have Humans of Glen.
Yeah.
Yes, we do have Humans of Glen, which I am a part of. It is a showcast of all the students here and their different personalities and aspects.
So, if someone's walking around with a notepad and paper and they don't have a camera, they're probably student going to interview people.
Yeah, we try to like pull people at random just to get like a feel of who goes to the school and like what they do.
So Clarabelle, our social media manager, is in charge of the promotion, and this year we took a different approach because we never had an Instagram or a Twitter before, and a lot of people would come up to us and ask what the newspaper is. They had no idea that it even existed, which was an issue that needed to be resolved. So, Clarabelle, how is managing the social media? What's that like?
Well, the social media is, well, we have a Twitter and Instagram, and on the Twitter, we live stream, like, the different football events. Like, we live stream homecoming and had videos, and we're going to live stream, like, future sports events as well. And the Instagram is just, like, what we do, but so people can see the process of being a newspaper. And it's been fun. Being the social media manager, it's interesting to see how we can showcase what we do.
Yeah, and I think also a part of social media is kind of like the website, just a little bit, kind of doing things to get people to want to read stories, you know, like choosing the right images, especially because we actually have to take all of our pictures now. We can't, like, you know, if we write a story about a book, we can't put a picture of the book cover on there. We actually have to take a picture of the book because we can't get copyrighted. So that's been fun.
Yeah.
Money.
Yeah,
money.
Sue us or something.
It goes back to the foundations of journalism. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it definitely does. And we don't want to do that because we want to keep publishing for the newspaper. So yeah, we have to take all of our own pictures, and choosing the right pictures to kind of like get people to want to click on stories, even choosing to put a picture or not, you know, and then choosing the right graphics, writing headlines for stories to kind of get people. I kind of think of it as doing like clickbait to try to get people to read the stories. And then also we have polls on the website. Like there was a poll about like your favorite type of sports and stuff like that. And then seeing who's voting on the polls, seeing our like site engagement and stuff like that.
We got a lot on that one.
Yeah, we had a bunch of voters on one poll about sports, like which one was your favorite sport. But then we do like seasons, like what's your favorite season, stuff like that. Just ways to get people to interact with the website. Do we want to talk about editing?
We can talk about how we do our pitch meetings.
Oh, yeah. The pitch meetings are fun.
So we basically write on our little whiteboard, like news, feature, miscellaneous, and editorial. And then we all bring our ideas to class that day. And we tell whoever's writing, and we all just have all of our story ideas just listed out on the board, and we go through them and assign the ones that each person wants. So that way each of our staff members aren't actually just like writing a story that they like don't want to write. Like they actually picked that story and they want to write it. So
yeah. And with our pitch meetings, we try to kind of assign stories based on relevance or like timeliness as well. Like we want people to write about stories about things that are happening right now, as opposed to other things where we can keep those on a list and kind of come back to them later if it's an ongoing thing or it's happening later on.
Yeah, we
so we have that. Ideas for the future as well.
We want to make sure that you guys are always getting relevant stories.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. In a timely manner. Yes, that's the goal there.
Mm-hmm. Well, where can they find our wonderful newspaper?
Well, we have our website, which is www.ghsgrowl.com. GHS spelled G-H-S, G-R-O-W-L. And then our Twitter and then our Twitter is ghsgrowl, like our website. And then our Instagram is ghsthegrowl.
There you can see all of the staff members. We have so many this year, which is way more than we've had.
Yeah.
We always have like five. And now we have like 15.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
last year, our staff was five people.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, it was really only four active writers. And then now we have a staff of, I think, 12 people, 11 or 12 or something like that. So we're definitely working with a lot more people, which is great. And a lot more different grade levels too. We have some sophomores, we have some juniors, and we have seniors as well.
Yes, so there's a mix. And we work with our Journalism 1 students. We teach them how to write news stories so that they can get some experience for the future people of the newspapers.
Yes.
If you want to join newspaper, you have to take J1 as a prerequisite.
Yeah, which is Journalism 1. Or you can also take photojournalism, but if you take that, that's more of a yearbook track than a newspaper track.
So if you're interested in joining newspaper or becoming a part of the journalism program, there will be applications at the end of the year.
Yeah, they're usually available like later spring semester.
Yes. And anyone who's passionate about writing, about world events, current events, creativity, it takes a lot of that.
Or just like wants to be involved in
anyone
school.
Who's interested in competing in UIL academics,
yes.
too.
Yes.
It's a great way to compete on UIL.
Love it.
Yes.
Yeah, and we also need a wide variety of people. So if there's someone out there that really likes sports and wants to just write about exclusively like sports games and stuff like that, consider joining the newspaper and represent sports. If there's somebody that's really involved in like theater or some other fine arts, you know, consider joining newspaper and representing your elective in the paper with the stories you write.
It's a good platform for the students to have a voice. And so if you're interested in ever joining, like we said, the applications will be available in the spring semester.
Okay, well, I think that's about all that we plan to talk about today. Thank you so much for listening.
Thanks.
Yes. Bye.